namaskar and adab to all my friends. I'm bringing this video to you about the recent transit of Jupiter in its Gandanta zone in conjunction with Saturn and Ketu into Sagittarius. Now this is a very important transition of Jupiter and in conjunction with the transit of Ketu and Saturn, because this happens once in about 137 years where Jupiter is passing through its Gandanta zone while in conjunction in transit with Ketu and Saturn as well. Now where is Jupiter passing into Sagittarius from? The Gandanta zone is from the 29th degree of Scorpio, which is a very watery sign, into a very fiery sign of Sagittarius, into the first degree of Sagittarius. And this is a very important Gandanta zone because Scorpio denotes the house of death, also the house of transformation, the house of sudden changes, house of sudden events which bring about a huge change, and into Sagittarius, which is the house of luck, fate, high learning. So this means that the death of some old things, Gandanta, end of a knot or unraveling of a knot. So the death of or a transformation or a huge change coming about through a sudden event, and the regeneration or a rebirth of fate or luck. And because it is happening in conjunction with Ketu and Saturn, this change could be either for very good or it could also be for a very bad. Now for those people who have a conjunction of either Ketu or Jupiter in their horoscope, or even a conjunction of Ketu or Saturn, or all three put together in any houses, then this becomes all the more very important for them, because some event will come by you in this particular period. And why so? Ketu is a very, very spiritual planet denoting moksha. Moksha is about letting go of everything, leaving everything behind and moving on even from this world into higher planes. Jupiter owns the 12th house of Pisces, which is again a very, very spiritual sign. So because Jupiter owns that, and Jupiter also denotes higher learning, rising higher at a spiritual level. And Saturn is a very strong karmic equalizer, owns and rules the 10th house and the 11th house. So all three coming together itself is a very, very important sign. And Ketu is a separator. It will separate you or absorb the goodness or even the bad effects of the house that it sits in. So Ketu being a very separative planet, sitting with Jupiter and Saturn, some event will come by you, either a big good opportunity will come by you, or something definitely will happen. Now, each one of us, we need to look into a natal chart and see. Now, each one of us, we need to look into a natal chart and see where the transition is happening for our respective houses. So, if, for example, in a natal chart, Jupiter is placed in Libra, for example, then Libra will anyways come into play. Plus Scorpio, because Ketu rules Scorpio, Sagittarius, because the transition is happening there. Capricorn, because Saturn owns Capricorn, Aquarius, because Saturn also owns Aquarius, and Pisces, ruled by Jupiter. So all these five houses will come into play if you're for a Libra ascendant, if any of these three planets is placed in Libra, for example. So for a Libra ascendant, first house is the Libra, then second house is Scorpio, third house is Sagittarius, fourth house is Capricorn, and fifth house is Aquarius, and sixth house is Pisces. So all the six houses will come into play. If Ketu, Jupiter and Saturn are placed in three different houses, from either the Scorpio or Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius or Pisces, into any other signs, then these four houses and those three houses come into play. So this is a very, very important time where lot of planetary transitions and effects could happen together. This is an opportunity for you to correct things and to let go of old baggage. And it's a renewal time for you. So make use of this renewal time. If you have wronged some people, if you've cheated some people, if you think there are people who carry any hurt against you or any animosity, this is the time to reach out and to make amends. This is the time to bring about a change. If the transition is happening in your fourth house, for example, then the effects of the fourth house will come into play. Property issues, vehicle issues, and any comforts and investments, health of mother, all will come into play. And because some people also believe that 10th house or Saturn is also the Karaka of father, father's health may also come into play. If it's happening in the 9th house, then long distance travel or fate could change. Your higher learning could be affected. Your learning for going for higher degrees or PhDs may come into play, which means you may either want to go for higher learning. So if there is something which has been a break for so long, suddenly that may come about. Sudden foreign travels may come about, or even a sudden break may come about where you don't know why things are not happening as you planned. So please note that wherever this transition is happening, in whichever house plus whatever houses are involved, change will happen, either for the good or the bad. So be prepared, know where the transition is happening in your natal charts. What is the strength of the planet? If Ketu is stronger than Jupiter and Saturn is also stronger than Jupiter, then more negative effects can come into play. For those people who have an affliction or challenges, and life is already going through challenges, then a lot of changes may also happen in your mind or at your emotional level because of Ketu and Saturn energy being very predominant. Especially if Ketu or Saturn is placed in your 8th house or your 12th house in your natal chart, then very weird, vivid dreams may happen and even premonitions or intuitive power may also come about. So keep this in mind. If you have any people who you feel are going or have some demonic forces or satanic influences, or you feel that, or some black magic, such forces may also show up or throw up more. If you are a believer, if you're not a believer, it's okay. So know where the transition is happening. Know in which direction the strength of your planets is denoting, which houses they are pointing towards. So whichever houses Jupiter, Saturn, Ketu are placed in your natal charts, they will come into play. Plus these four houses, Scorpio, Sagittarius, Capricorn, Aquarius and Pisces, these five houses, they will come into play. So you will get mixed results of all five. If Jupiter, Ketu and Saturn are placed in important houses, say for example 2nd, 4th, 7th or 10th, then there will be changes or opportunities around that. 10th house, there may be changes or opportunities of career, sudden changes in career, sudden role change, even being asked to leave, asked to go, or a good things coming by, any of these can happen. So please look into your natal charts, please understand your planetary position and be prepared. Because while don't read this as a regular transition which is happening, because this is a very important transition, and you will only be you will only have yourself to blame if after a month when Jupiter goes back into retrograde, you have not made use of this time and you have not made amends or not corrected things or used this opportunity or being careful during this time. And this transition will happen again when November comes for a few months. So we will talk about that later when that comes. So for now, I would request you to look into your charts and be prepared. Until we meet for some other video, this is your friend signing off. Ciao.